YouTube, what is going on everybody? It's Joe Moore and I am back with another tutorial video for you all. In today's video, I'm going to be explaining the histogram, the five different types of an exposure within the histogram, and how to be able to read it and understand it in general for your next video and photo project. Now hold on guys, before we get into this video, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button and hit that bell button to stay up to date with all the video content, all the photo content, and all the content in general that I'm gonna be dropping on this channel. So let's go ahead and hop into this video. So the first things first, let's explain what a histogram is. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to understand what a histogram is, and the best way to do that is to pull up the definition of a histogram. A histogram is a representation of the pixels exposed in your image. The left side of the histogram is gonna be your blacks and shadows, the right side of the histogram is gonna be your highlights and bright areas, and the middle section of your histogram is gonna be your midtones. Alright guys, so the next thing we need to do is we need to go over the five exposure levels of the histogram. So the five exposure levels of the histogram is going to be underexposed, exposed to the left, or ETTL for short, neutral exposure, exposed to the right, or ETTR, and finally overexposed. Those are going to be the five exposure levels of a histogram, so once you understand them, it's going to help you while you're on set or taking photos in general. Now for this video, I use Creative Ryan as an example, and I took photos of him outside during the daytime, so I'll be able to show you the five exposure levels of the histogram using photos of C. Ryan as an example. So let's go ahead and hop into Lightroom and I'll show you the five exposure levels of the histogram.
Okay guys, now that we're in Lightroom, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go from the right to the left. So I'm gonna deal with the overexposed shots and show you what that would look like, going all the way down to the underexposed shots. So basically the overexposed shots, as you could tell from the graph that I displayed earlier, you're gonna lose all the data in the overexposed aspect because everything's blown out. So all the stuff that's in the overexposed line means that you've lost the data and it's not able to come back. So basically think of it like an audio representation. If you recorded audio and you screamed in the mic and it hit those red levels, it means you've lost the data there, you can't get it back. So let's go ahead and deal with this one first. So I'll show you what it's gonna look like. And I've actually gone down here and I've color coded all of the photos that I took with C. Ryan on set just to let me know which ones are which. So in Lightroom, what I usually do first is I come over here on the right hand side and I click the shadow clipping as well as the highlight clipping. So as soon as I click the highlight clipping, you can see everything that's clipped is in red, which means it is clipped, aka it is overexposed, and we've lost the detail in that. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to the right hand side and I'm going to bring the exposure down and try to take out some of these clippings. Okay, let's leave it right about there. And I'm gonna bring the contrast up. I'm gonna leave the temperature and the tint where it is. Let's go ahead and mess with the highlights, the shadows, the whites, and the blacks. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring the whites down. Next, I'm gonna bring the highlights down. Now I'm gonna leave the blacks and the shadows where they are, but if I was to mess around with the blacks or the shadow slider, you could see what would happen if I brought down the blacks the same way how on the right side it shows the clippings for the highlights, will also show the clippings for the shadows and dark areas. Instead of the shadows being in red, it's going to be in blue, and we don't want that, so I'm gonna go ahead and double click the blacks, put it back to zero. Now, presence is just a artistic standpoint. It's what you want it to look like. So, you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and pick the settings that I usually do for this. I'm gonna put the clarity up to about 25, put the vibrance up to about 20, and I'm gonna leave the saturation where it is. Now let's go down to the curves and mess with this. I'm gonna leave the darks and the shadows where they are, and I'm going to bring the highlights. Well, first I'm gonna bring the lights down, put it to about negative 25, and I'm gonna mess with the highlights some as well. Put that down to about 25 as well. So now let's go ahead and mess with the HSLs. Now everything after this point is just an artistic standpoint and it's artistic expression. It's just your preference. It's how you want your photo to look. I mean, once you deal with the actual exposure, everything after that is just how you want your shot to look. Everybody has a different editing style. You could have 10 people stand in the same spot and take the same photo and then have them go edit the photo. They're all gonna look different. So let's go ahead and mess with the HSLs. I'm gonna come down to my sharpening and usually I put this at, let's see here, I think that's good right there. Bring the radius down and bring the detail down. And let's do the masking at right about there. Go ahead and click the remove chromatic abrasion, excuse me if I pronounced that wrong, and enable profile corrections. And I'm gonna bring the Vegeta down to right about there. And I'm gonna go ahead and level out the photo and leave everything else down here. So this is the before photo. As you can see, all of the highlights that have been clipped and that the data has been lost in, and now the after. Now again, some people would choose to bring this up a little bit more, but because it's been clipped in the highlights, I kind of want to keep it down to the -2.80, because once you start bringing it up, you're gonna lose and see more of the lost detail in the actual photo. So that's gonna be the overexposed shot that I've now edited. As you can tell up in here, we've lost the details in the highlights, especially the clouds and different parts of the photo in the highlights. It's something you can't get back, and the detail you won't be able to pull back in. So let's go ahead and move to the next shot, which is gonna be the exposure to the right, which I've put in purple coding. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy everything that I did in the overexposed shot and bring it over to the exposed to the right. Now, obviously, once I hit paste on this, it's not going to be set for the exposed to the right shot, but I'm just gonna tweak it because that's the basis of where I can start from and start tweaking everything instead of literally going down and doing everything over again. So let's go ahead and hit paste. Now, as you can see, it's darker in this shot, but if you look at the overexposed shot compared to the exposed to the right shot, we still have details in the highlights as opposed to the overexposed shot. We've lost details in all of the highlights and different parts of this photo. So let's go back over to the exposed to the right. Now I'm gonna bring this up. And at this point, all of the photos that aren't overexposed, the underexposed shot, the exposed to the left shot, the neutral exposure, and the exposed to the right shot is all gonna be preference on how you want your photo to look, because there is no clippings on the actual photo. There's no overexposure on the photo. So as long as you don't push any slider to the left, to the far left, or to the far right, it's up to you how you want your photo to look. An example of that would be, I can still push this exposure up and create it to where it's now becoming clipping in the highlights, but I'm not gonna do that. So just leave the shot here. I'm gonna bring the whites up and leave the highlight where it is. Come down here, bring the lights back up. Nope. And also, easier way to see where your clipping is, if you hit the option button on your Mac and then slide over, all of this stuff right here that you see is everything that's overexposed in the shot. Or if you were using the blacks and you hold option, that's now everything that is clipping to the left in your darks and your shadows. Let's go ahead and put that back. Bring this back up. All right, now we're clipping in the highlights. Bring this down. There we go. So this is gonna be the before. On the exposed to the right, a little bit of clippings in the highlight section, and the after editing shot. So the next one's gonna be the neutral exposure. Again, I'm gonna copy the settings from the exposure to the right. And the neutral exposure I've put in the blue. So let's go over here and hit the paste. All right, we're gonna bring this up. And bring the highlights up. And put this exposure back down a little bit. And I'm gonna bring my blacks down a little bit. Clipping. There we go, leave that up, Hold on. Okay. Bring the highlights down a little bit till we get rid of that clipping. Okay. All right, let's go ahead and move to the exposed to the left, which is in yellow. All right, let's reset the lights and the highlights in the region. Let's come up here and reset the whites and the highlights. Bring the whites up just a little bit till it starts clipping, and the highlights, bring that down. Put the whites back down, get rid of that clipping right there. And there's a little bit of clipping in the shadows. Okay, and here's the before and the after. Let's go ahead and raise the exposure up just a little bit. Here's the before and here's the after. And the last one's gonna be the underexposed shot, which I've set in the green label over here to the right. As you can see, there's a lot of clipping in the shadow dark area on the left hand side. So let's go ahead and paste the settings from the exposure to the left. Okay. Let's bring the exposure up. Let's bring the contrast down. Let's bring the blacks down. And the shadows down. Let's bring the whites up a little bit. And the highlights up. Let's try to bring it up in the region in the shadows. And a little bit in the darks. Let's bring the shadows up in the tone a little bit. And add some saturation. So here's the before and here's the after. And you could actually come over here in Lightroom and click on this, which will show you the before and after. So let's go ahead and go through these shots real quick. You have the overexposed. You have the exposure to the right. You have the neutral exposure, exposure to the left, and the underexposed. So guys, that's gonna be the five exposure levels and how I would edit them within Lightroom for each exposure level. Once you deal with everything on the histogram in your editing platform, everything else after that with the HSLs and stuff relating to color and saturation and clarity and sharpening, that's just all how you want your photo to look once you've gotten your settings in the histogram correct.
So guys, there's no such thing as a perfect exposure because every setting and every scenario is not going to be the same, which means it's going to produce different data on your histogram and the graph in general. A couple examples of that would be if you went outside and you took photos in a bright white area such as the snow, or you went outside and took photos in the dark areas such as nighttime or just anywhere in general that's darkly lit. The photos taken in the white bright areas are gonna lean towards the right side of your histogram, while the dark shadowy areas is gonna lead towards the left side of your histogram. Those two photos is gonna produce different results and show different data within your histogram. In each scenario, all you're trying to do is make sure that you're not either overexposed or underexposed. So there's no such thing as perfect exposure, it's just getting the best exposure for your current setting. Now, similar to the histogram that's showing your luminance, the RGB histograms is going to be showing you where your color data is falling within the exposure levels on the histogram. You're able to go back and forth between these two different histogram settings within your camera. Just go within your camera and find the histogram and you should be able to find the RGB section and the luminance section. The easiest way to be able to tell what your current histogram setting is go look through your viewfinder and you'll either see RGB, which is the red, green, and blue section of the histogram, or you'll see a bright white, which is your luminance histogram. So that's gonna be the basics of the histogram and being able to understand how to use your histogram next time you're taking photos or video to get the best exposure levels for that current setting. Thanks guys for watching the video. Be sure to like, comment, and share this video, as well as subscribe to the YouTube channel so you can stay up to date with all the content that I'm gonna be dropping on this channel. Appreciate you all.